May 27th, 2020. That was 2 days after the death of George Floyd. Reports say La Mesa police officer Matthew Dages spotted someone he thought was smoking at a trolley station, which is not allowed. Officer Dages ended up arresting the suspect, Amari Johnson, for assault on a police officer. Video, which you're watching right now, of this incident taken by one of Johnson's friends went viral, resulting in rioting and protests that destroyed much of the business district in La Mesa. Now, Officer Dages was eventually cleared by the police use of force department after being fired. But now criminal charges are pending. They've been filed against him, against Officer Dages, for filing a false police report. And joining me now to discuss this case is the wife of that former La Mesa police officer, Christina Dages. Christina, thank you for talking with us tonight.
Thank you so much for having me.
Now, I understand your husband can't speak to us because of the pending litigation, correct?
Correct.
Okay. So let's start with this. After that video went viral, what happened to your family?
There were protests at our home immediately that same night. There were actually multiple protests at our home. Our personal information was doxxed online. We got death threats. It was unrelenting, and we ended up having to sell our home that we had just purchased for safety reasons.
Wow, so you were fearing for your life after this.
Absolutely. The threat came right to our doorstep, literally.
My goodness. All right, so what assignment was your husband actually working on for the La Mesa Police Department when this incident happened?
Matthew was assigned by La Mesa to work a trolley enforcement detail that day, along with other police officers from the department. So the purpose of that detail is saturation. So officers are there to contact everyone on MTS property because the trolley station is a very high crime area in La Mesa. So the police department schedules these trolley enforcement details regularly.
Okay, and so he, according to the reports that I've read, he thinks he sees Amari Johnson smoking. He goes up to Amari Johnson, and what happens at that point?
The detention was for not having a valid trolley pass. Detentions are very routine in law enforcement. They should last about 30 to 60 seconds. Someone provides their name, their date of birth. They're run through the system. And for these specific trolley enforcement details, it's more of a warning, right? An educational moment. So you're just told next time you have to have a trolley fare to be on MTS property. You're free to go about your day. So that's how the interaction should have gone. But because this person did not cooperate, the situation had to escalate to a low level use of force.
Yeah. And then actually he's arrested for assault on a police officer. What happened there?
Correct. So that's actually captured on the body worn camera footage, as well as the subject admitting to striking the police officer, my husband. So that's ultimately what he was arrested for, was striking a peace officer during his detention for not having a valid trolley pass.
And then what action did the La Mesa Police Department take after this video went viral?
Well, immediately after the riots, the city of La Mesa approached Matthew with a six-figure offer to resign voluntarily. We can be honest about that. You don't get paid a dime by your employer if you've done something wrong. But that was their initial response. La Mesa tried to pay Matthew to resign, and Matthew declined because, one, he knew his use of force was within policy, and two, Matthew knew that resigning would look like resignation in lieu of termination. And that would negatively affect his ability to be a police officer somewhere else. And that's his passion and purpose in life. So Matthew declined La Mesa's six-figure offer. And then they alluded to us that they'd be willing to hire an outside investigative firm to essentially produce an adverse finding against Matthew to force him out, which is exactly what they did. Matthew was cleared for low-level use of force, but the city found essentially loopholes to fire him for political reasons.
Explain to me what those loopholes are.
So it basically boils down to semantics or word choice. In Matthew's police report, everything in his police report is corroborated by other police officers, other witnesses, La Mesa's own use of force expert. But essentially, it's a loophole that allows La Mesa to railroad Matthew in this case.
And that's kind of where we're at now, because I understand the district attorney has filed criminal charges for lying on a police report. So what are they saying he lied about?
observations, essentially. So his initial observation of smoking was just that. He approached the subject, told him he couldn't smoke there. The subject denied smoking. Matthew didn't see any evidence of smoking. Matthew moved on in the conversation. It was a consensual encounter. It was during that conversation, it was learned the person didn't have a trolley pass on MTS property. So that initial observation is something they're trying to take issue with, even though it is immaterial to the reason he was detained and arrested. And then body language. So other officers on the scene, as well as La Mesa's use of force expert, all corroborate this person was combative, pre-assaultive, that they struck Matthew. And yet when Matthew describes those same behaviors, La Mesa is trying to say he's not credible, but everyone else who describes those behaviors is. So like I said, it's basically down to semantics or word choice.
And now those charges were filed by the DA in January, but your prelim, his prelim, keeps getting kicked back and it's supposed to happen next week. Is that correct?
Correct. It's been continuously delayed. And so we've just been kind of in constant agony wanting to get this case dismissed because it's completely unfounded. As I said, everything in Matthew's police report is corroborated by witnesses, other officers, and even La Mesa's own use of force expert. Additionally, Matthew passed a voluntary polygraph about the incident, further proving that there's no dishonesty, no racial bias happened. And there's even a lot of case law that backs Matthew. So we know that the criminal case against him is unfounded. It's very politically motivated. And our expectation is that criminal charges should be dropped immediately.
Well, I also understand that he's applying for dismissal an appeal for his dismissal. Why does he want to go back to La Mesa Police Department?
Well, his being a police officer is his passion and his purpose in life. It truly is a calling. But you are right. We're essentially fighting a war on two fronts. So there's the unfounded criminal case that we want dropped. And then there's also this administrative case that we're appealing La Mesa's decision to terminate Matthew. So that appeal will go before a Superior Court judge here soon. And they, for the first time in 14 months, will actually weigh the evidence of this case. And, you know, one thing that the public doesn't know is that La Mesa's standard of proof for their investigation is astonishingly low. And that's allowed them to move forward with these allegations that are not backed by evidence. So we're very confident that we will prevail in this appeals process. And we look forward to clearing Matthew's name and getting him reinstated. You know, this is a police officer with zero history of discipline or complaints at La Mesa Police Department. His personnel file is filled with commendations. He received an award for compassion. And just a few months before this incident, the chief of police himself called Matthew a role model officer. So our family really believes it's time to end this wrongful villainization of Matthew and just allow us and the community to move forward.
Clearly, the story is developing really quickly. Where can folks go to find out more about this case and to follow you?
Yes, go to Instagram and follow the account Clear Officer Dages. That's D as in David, A-G-E-S, Clear Officer Dages on Instagram for case updates and easy ways you can join us in the fight for justice.
All right. Well, we, of course, are going to be at the prelim next week if it happens. Christina Dages, thank you so much for talking with us tonight. I appreciate it.
Thank you.